Broadcasting live worldwide.
Welcome. Are you ready? Welcome.
Señoras y señores, welcome a Diálogo con Luis Otero.
So welcome to everyone to another edition of Dialogo with Luis Otero. I'm your host, Luis Otero. Thank you to everyone that they're listening today and they're watching us all around today, around the world today. So I really appreciate all of you for watching and supporting Dialogo. We have already 35,000 downloads so far in just the beginning of the show. We have over, this is going to be our... I think it's going to be like our 12th, 13th episode. We don't know yet, but we have over 35,000 downloads worldwide. So I want to thank everyone that they've been supporting the show via audio and as well via video. We already have accumulated over 100,000 views in YouTube and Dailymotion. So we thank you so much for supporting us. And please follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Dialogo con Otero. Today we have a tremendous... I'm super excited for the show. First of all, I got to say this. I'm very excited because we have a tremendous representation of what truly Latina women are in the movie, entertainment, and Hollywood business. Our guest today... have been in the movie business for many, many, many years. She have worked with likes and actors and singers like Luther Vandross, have worked with Billy Bob Thornton, and have worked in series like Law and Order, ER, Southland, the TV series The Mentalist, Cage, Pure Genius, have worked in Shameless, and... She have a tremendous role as Violet Webster in the new season of the Amazon amazing series Goliath. I got the true honor and pleasure to have in Dialogo with Luis Otero, the amazing, the one and only, the number one Latina in Goliath, Marisa Echevarria. Welcome to Dialogo with Luis Otero. It's a great pleasure to have you today in the show. Thank you for the
Thank
trust.
Thank you, Luis. I'm so happy to be here. Thanks for inviting me.
No, it's a true honor to have you. I have been following your career since the beginning of the series of Goliath, but you had a tremendous career for many years that a lot of people don't even know about that I would love to talk, you know, about you today, but more likely, you know, to know more about who Marisa is and how she have been able to accomplish this kind of success at this stage in the career that, you know, you have that is being a tremendous career because you've been in tremendous projects involved, you know, since the beginning of your life. But we're going to have a very great chat today. So I'm looking forward to it.
Great. I'm excited.
So Marisa, you were born in the beautiful city of Los Angeles, California, many years ago, but coming from a Latina background, correct?
Yes, yes. I was born in Los Angeles, but my father was born in Mexico. He's the son of a mariachi violinist who did a lot of traveling as mariachi. He came up to Los Angeles and San Francisco and New York even, and so decided she was going to bring the family up and join him here. So that's how they came to Los Angeles.
Awesome. So you're from Mexican background. Do any one of them were involved in the entertainment business? Because you seem like a natural with all the, no. You know, on camera and in the and in the series in Goliath with your role as a Violet Webster. That is really impressive the way that you act in the series. Do anyone was involved with the industry at that point?
No, my grandfather was the only performer. He played the violin and he sang. I got my love of music and musical background. It's my blood. But no one else. It was I'm kind of a black sheep in that way.
Gotcha. So why would you started, you know, acting? Because I got some very interesting notes over here that your first role, well, how you get your, you know, Screen Actors Guild card was singing, not acting, was singing with Luther Vandross, the song Heart of a Hero.
Yeah.
In the amazing movie Hero that, you know, Dustin Hoffman is the main guy, the main character in the movie with Gina Davis. How that came about? That's 1992. That's over 20 years ago.
I was really young and I was in a choir. Well, our music teacher was starting a children's choir and she asked my parents if I would be involved because she thought I had singing talent.
Correct.
And I really wanted to. And so I wound up joining the choir and singing with all these amazing performers and singers and musicians. And one of the things, a few of us, we soundtrack with Luther Vandross. And it was just an incredible experience. And he was such a warm, fantastic performer, obviously, to be in a room with for that long and kind of share that attention and that connection with him. And it was a great way to, you know, to learn a lot on kind of like low pressure situation. So that's, and that is how I got my SAG card, although I didn't use it for many, many years.
Of course. And definitely it takes time sometimes when, obviously, when you're in such a young age, just to learn if you want to go the acting way or you want to like be a singer or be something else in
sure.
life.
And like, yeah. And just as you said, Luis, my family wasn't familiar with it. So they weren't super excited. They were supportive, but they were cautious because they didn't know if I could to, you know, an acting career. So, all in a different way, but I got.
Gotcha. So how really you decided and at what point in life you decided to, hey, Marisa, I want to be an actress. How it came that about? Because I have seen that you have done everything in the movie business. You were a director for two shorts, Los Angeles, or like Angeles was one of the shorts that you did, and you were a director in Body and Blood. And then, you know, you've been on a roll for many, many years on, you know, in a big stage with a lot of great TV series. When you find out that you were gonna, you said, I'm gonna do this for a living, because it takes a lot of faith. It takes a lot of like, you know, trust into your, you know, skills to just become a full-time actress. And a Latina sometimes too, because, and I gotta say this, because they tend to be a little bit typecast sometimes. And I just don't like that, because obviously we can do any kind of role, but you maybe face some challenges at the beginning. How do you learn that you were going to be an actress? Do you said, I'm going to be an actress, doesn't matter what?
It's so many good things you just brought up. I guess I really determined that I was going to be an actress around college because I had a director come, Elizabeth Suedo's name, and direct me in a show. And it was the first time I think that I saw someone else see me really and know that I had it and support me in that way. Someone who had a history and who was so gifted herself. So sometimes it takes somebody else to kind of ignite them. And she did that for me. So she asked me to be in a show in New York and I took the leap. I left school for a while and I did that at the beginning of my acting career. And then when I graduated from college, I got a fellowship to NYU's acting program.
Wow.
And I went to NYU, and then that's when things really took off because I was able to get an agent and start getting booked on TV shows. So, and theater, a lot of theater.
That's really awesome. NYU have a tremendous acting program, but just getting the step of just getting an agent sometimes is not really easy for any up and coming, you know, actors or actresses or, you know, anyone that wants to, you know, live from this, you know, having someone to trust and say, I am going to support you or be that person to watch and provide you those castings or opportunities, it just really says a lot from you just reaching out. So definitely got to give you a lot of credit, because not a lot of people coming out from the NYU program, they can just get an agent, you know, it takes sometimes even years.
And I think it is about now there's a lot more possibility of creating your own work and showing yourself in that way. At that time, it was really helpful to have a school where you could do a showcase and have people see you and then maybe call you, you know, but that's exactly right. And you spoke about directing, Luis, and I've always directed first theater, but as far back as high school, you know, I was really starting to do little shows, and then graduate school I directed while I was in grad school, and then I wound up starting to do short films when I've been out here in LA, and that's been really amazing and always a way for me to feel like I'm growing in a different way.
I feel that really gives you a different edge in as well in the set when you're working with such, you know, amazing actors like Billy, you know, Bob Thornton, you know, in the new, you know, in the series Goliath, you've been, you know, having a tremendous role. I gotta say, you know, with Violet Webster, is such a great character, and as well Shameless. I think it brings you, you know, it brings a lot to the table when you have done all those roles. The pace maybe and the way that you see everyone on the set, because I think that you understand every single role and as well how you should be, you know, looking at the camera or speaking or maybe just working better with the whole staff. I think that that brings a lot of value at the end of the day, you know, in your craft, in your work. So I feel that definitely.
Thank you. Yes, absolutely. And I think.
And I feel that really like you have showed that, you know, in the series Goliath, but you did roles with Law and Order, a small role with Law and Order, and you have done roles with ER. I am seeing the whole list, and it's a lot of work, you know, that you have done. So you did start at the beginning in New York, and then you did the move to Los Angeles, again, going back home, correct?
Yes, that's exactly right. I was in New York. I did a lot of theater in New York. I did Shakespeare in the Park and a lot of things like that. And wow. Then I also did these television shows like Rescue Me. And I was in Law and Order, which, you know, you mentioned before, roles that feel a little more stereotyped, you know. And early on, I felt like I went in for a lot. I always wanted to get on Law and Order, and I kept going in for casting, and they kept calling me in for like gangbang types because that
really
was,
wow,
that was the majority of the roles on that show were like criminals, you know, because it's Law and Order, but. I felt like, oh, this isn't right for me. You know, I don't know. That doesn't feel right. And finally I got a role that was had a little more substance. And it was someone who was a mom and had lost her husband in the war. And, you know, so it was something I could sink my teeth into, but I feel like sometimes we book roles that we can identify with, that there's something that we respect about the role. And that's certainly true about Goliath. And that has been true about a lot of the roles that I've done. I have to have something fun or something that I believe in that the character stands for. And so that matters to me. And that matters in Latino representation, you know, because if we don't have characters that we can get behind and stand up for, then we're missing a part of us that's being represented on the screen.
I agree. And Violet Webster is a great representative of just empowering. It's a very empowering role, you know. And I feel that definitely when you look at that, you know, script, you said, this is for me immediately as soon as you saw it.
Yeah, it was one of those magic roles where I felt like everything came together just the right way and came to me at a time when I was ready for it. And yeah, I walked into that audition and really felt like there was kind of a magic in the air. So it's really cool to get that role.
No, it definitely is a very cool role. And it's going for the third season now. And definitely you still... Yeah. Are in it, and that definitely says a lot of your work and the writers too, because they have considered you for the third season, you know. And that sets obviously a lot of the body of work and the discipline, because I feel that just it's a very powerful series, you know, of this, you know, amazing, I just say, you know, this amazing, powerful lawyer, one was powerful lawyer, you know, that's Billy McBride, and, you know, and he's washed up, and it's just have a lot of powerful characters inside of the series. And what Violet Webster represents is just a very important role. And I think you represent pretty well the Latinas in the role. So I got to commend you for that, because I think that really brings a great edge. And obviously it's not a typecast. That's the best part of it. You know?
Thank you. Yeah. And I've always been a fan of the show. I feel like it's one of these amazing series that is happening at a time where we need to see it, because it's talking about people who are weak, who feel weak, like Billy McBride, who, you're right, was once at the top of his game and now is really this kind of washed up guy, but he still has a voice.
Correct.
And he can still use his voice on behalf of people who need it. And it's something that strengthens him, and it's something that strengthens his community. And I have just loved this show. So I'm really, really excited. And I think all the actors on it are so phenomenal. So it's been a real pleasure. It was kind of a dream to be on that set, you know, again and again, and it was great.
It'd have to be an impressive set. I can't imagine with, you know, guys like I saw in the credits, you know, obviously Billy Bob, you know, Thornton's just the main guy, but you have Dennis Quaid in the you know, in the set, just having those great names and obviously being around those great guys and just, you know, representing us as Latinos and obviously as a community that we're growing this beautiful country and we're definitely making our mark. I think that definitely is just a tremendous, you know, it's tremendous to see you in the series. Going back very quickly to Shakespeare on the Park and your foundation as an actress, Raul Julia did Shakespeare on the Park. phenomenal. I think that was a historical role that he played with Meryl Streep at the beginning, you know, of his career. You decide to take that same path. That I can't imagine how much that played on your foundation just to become the actress that you are today. Could you explain how was the experience on Shakespeare in the Park in such a demanding crowd, obviously, you know, in such a workshop? You know?
Oh, it was incredible. I feel so lucky to have had that experience. And there's nothing like theater in New York, first of all, and there's nothing like theater in Central Park being outside. There were nights that would just rain on you and you just let it rain down as you were acting the scenes. And you know what? The whole audience would pull out their umbrellas and just stay put and watch the whole show in these like torrential downpours. So New Yorkers are hardcore. They are ready to go. And it was incredible. It was so much fun. And I do think that you really do gain a strong foundation. And for me, theater was always the first stop on the, you know, on the ladder, especially because there are those actors that I admire so much that were always theater actors, Chita Rivera, Raul Julia, you know, all of these different actors that I looked up to, that I knew who they were and certainly saw them in film. But you can always feel an actor that has that kind of stage background. They're incredible. They're a 360.
Do after just leaving New York and going back to LA, your hometown, do it was easy to adapt from just doing theater so constantly to try to pursue, you know, going into movies? That is a different kind of like setup, because you get instant reaction on a theater, and then in movie you don't.
Sure. And it's now it feels different to me. I found my groove, I think, but you're absolutely right. There's a collaboration that happens on stage that is instantaneous. And when you're in a TV show, you don't get that kind of collaborative feel in the same way. You show up knowing your stuff, and you sometimes don't even see your scene partner until you're on set and you're shooting. So it can be very quick and it can have that feel to it. But once you trust that and let go into it, you get the same kind of fun vibe that you have on stage. It's just a matter of trust, really. And so I think I found that now, but you're right. It was an adjustment when we first moved back to LA, and I had never really lived in Hollywood. You know, I'd never really worked consistently in Hollywood before. And then I went to New York. And so, you know, I did a little bit of the singing and things like that, but it wasn't until I really moved here that I really got a feel for Hollywood. So that was really great.
No, I can't imagine. And now that you're finally on your groove, because you've been doing this for so many years now, and you had you had a lot of great roles that they have groomed you to this point. And I got to say it, because if you see the whole list of work that sometimes you're working and you don't pay attention to what you're currently doing. And then now you're looking back and you're like, wow, like this role was preparing me for this role now. And I wasn't prepared at that point, right, but now I'm prepared to this, you know. And I think you're right now, I feel that you're in the peak and there's so many great things coming on your way. You have Goliath and then you have Shameless with Lynn. I think that playing with those two roles, you know, and just having that kind of like balance between those two, do it's difficult to just shift from character from Lynn to just Violet Webster between those two series? Do the setup when you go to just act have to be, your mentality have to be different? Do you adapt different to different directors and just working around different people? Because I have seen people that they're like, it tends to be difficult for me to transition from role to role. I had the opportunity to speak many years ago to Joaquin Phoenix, that we did the Joker. And it's just really interesting because, he just said like, it's for me difficult to get out of character. And some other people, they're like, oh yeah, I can just disconnect easily from the character. Do you have that, you know, how do you adapt to those two different roles?
I think maybe because I'm a Pisces, I don't know. I love going in and out of character.
Yeah.
So I love it. I even, you know, even if I'm doing one thing in the morning and another thing in the afternoon, it doesn't bother me at all. And maybe it is theater, because sometimes you go on stage and you get it in your bones and you can kind of flip in and out of it. For me, I like that. I certainly like to take my time and get my head in the game if it's something that I have to pay attention to. But especially these two roles, I mean, Goliath's a drama and there's funny moments, but for the most part, it's a drama series. Yeah. And my role on Shameless, you know, the Shameless stuff is a lot more comedic. Oh, and yeah. My stuff certainly was very funny. And so I'm looking forward to seeing that in December and when it comes out. And but I loved being able to do both of those. And I love to be able to switch back and forth, especially between drama and comedy. I think it's so fun.
That's awesome. And do you find sometimes, and this is, you know, maybe you can answer to this. Do you have find on the way, you know, that maybe you're living, you know, in a normal day, that sometimes you find something of Violet Webster in you and you find something of Lynn in you and you're like, oh my God, like I never thought that I was going to like act this way. And it's true. And you find that character in your normal life.
Oh, for sure. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely, it's something that like you bring yourself to the character and then later on you see things come up and you think, oh, that's where that is. Yeah. Living inside of me.
Yeah.
And I like that because these characters offer something to hopefully the viewers, but they offer something to me too. And oftentimes it's strength and, you know, or it's like kind of a, I don't know, more, you know, funny side. Yeah. So it's good.
That's awesome. You are a mother, a wife, you know, like I always say, it's difficult because I'm a husband and a father, and it's difficult sometimes to juggle mm-hmm. professional life. And obviously your life as a, you know, as a mother, as a wife, and it's difficult because you're a mother of two, I'm a father of one and a husband too. And it's difficult to juggle both lives. How do you're able to just schedule your life with all this amazing work coming on your way? Because you're putting that great footprint of who Maurice Echevarria is as a Latina actress and as another great, strong woman with this great roles, but at the same time keeps home life, you know, stable. Do it's difficult sometimes to find the balance? I always ask this question because I tend to have the difficult, you know, it tends to be difficult sometimes for me to balance, just create a proper balance between home and professional life. Do you find that difficult too at the point of your career that you're at right now?
You know, it's always a balance, but you're right. As I get busier and my husband, you know, steps in to do certain things and we hand off, the balance constantly shifts.
Correct.
But I'm so grateful because I do have a partner that I can say, hey, you know, you're doing dinner tonight and I'm going to be here and you handle this tomorrow, and constant communication about that stuff. And we have family nearby, which is really great. So I'm grateful to my parents and I'm not afraid for help. You know, I think that it's important to my children to see me doing something that I love. I want to model that for them. And I want mother loves them and wants to know all about their lives and also is going to head out the door and, you know, make some money and
of course
come back. So I do think I do think that in a lot of ways I'm my best when I'm working, because when I come home, I'm so happy to be here and I'm happy to get into the domestic stuff and check homework and make meal and make their lunches. And I love it. And then I feel like I have more to give them. So I'm grateful for that. And I'm grateful for men like you who step up and acknowledge that it's home life.
It is important. I think that is important. I think that women these days, Latinas and from any single culture, I think that, you know, women like yourself, and I have to acknowledge you, you know, they are empowering and providing that role of like, I'm a mother, I'm a wife, but I can definitely do something as well. And live a life of purpose. That's what you're doing. You're living a life of purpose through your career as an actress and having those great platforms that you have to just demonstrate that. Look where I came from and look how I have come to this point on my career, you know,
yes.
Just having these two amazing roles, and you have a lot of other projects, you know, on the horizon as well. Maurice, at this point of your career, with these two great TV series that you're currently working, what is next for you? What is the next challenge for you? Do you have any visualization of where you see yourself in the next few years? I know that the entertainment and obviously movie business or feature film business is kind of, and the whole TV business is very unpredictable. But what kind of roles do you would like to see yourself doing in the future?
I loved the role on Goliath so much, and I hope that I can continue to have roles that feel that important to me. I think think I would love to do some more comedy. I think that would be really fun to get on a comedy series on a regular basis. Would be great. And I would love to. And I'm looking to direct or produce. There are a couple projects that I'm, working on that I think maybe I'll be able to step on the other side of the camera too. So, but I'm excited for what's coming.
Do you like more directing? Do you like more acting? Directing is just one director guiding the whole entire staff, crew, and you have the concept or the whole movie or short film or TV series or movie in your brain, and you're putting that to work through all the moving parts on the set. Do you like to do that more, or do you like to be more like directed or coached by just the director of Goliath, or the producers or the assistant producers? Do you like your role more as an actress, or you like both so much that you say, I cannot even choose between both?
I find that I have different, it depends on the project really, and what I think I feel like my strength would be for that project.
Correct.
So acting is something that I fall into very easily, and I can tell right away if I have a connection. And then there are stories that I want to tell, but I know that there's not a part for me, but, and that's at that point that I sort of go, oh, I'd love to direct that. And I can see it. I know how I would lead the way. And then there are things that I think about just that I'd love to be out in the world. So, and I could produce them. So, yeah.
It is extremely awesome. I saw the trailer of the new season of Goliath, that is going to be a third season. What as fans and viewers and people that respect your work should expect of this season with Violet Webster? What we should expect from her?
Oh my gosh, I don't even know what to tell you. It's so, so good. I think this season is really tremendous, and I've been a fan from the very beginning. So I hope that you'll tune in. It's October 4th, tomorrow is the day that it premieres, and you can see it on Amazon Prime. And it's such a thrilling show, and you've got a lot of superstars on this episode, on this season. So I know you'll enjoy it. So have fun with
it. No, it's going to be very fun. So October 4th, to everyone listening or watching, Goliath in Amazon Prime starts October 4th. It's going to be an amazing series. I saw the trailer. I cannot say enough from this amazing, amazing series. Super, thrilling, awesome drama. You see Marissa in his best, I think, acting performance. And I hope really to see you with, I really would love to see you with a Golden Globe. It will be awesome to see a Latina holding a Golden Globe for such an amazing series. Definitely. Because your role has been tremendous. And I think that should not be overlooked. I got to say this, and there's definitely a lot of great other actors. Billy Bob Thornton, Dennis Quaid is in this series, and I'm not going to say any more in this season. So it's going to be really good. Marissa, what do you have to say?
I know, there's a lot of surprises.
Oh, yeah. There are a lot of surprises of this season. Marissa, what message you would like to say to all the Latinas listening, Diálogo, with Luis Otero? What you would like to say to all of them, that they're in a situation maybe of, I don't know what to do with my life. I feel that I am good at this, but I don't know how to start. What you will say, because you were there at that point, what enlightening message you will provide them today?
I would say never give up. Keep finding different ways to try. It's okay to take a pause and figure something out. But I would say if you feel like you have a gift that you want to give and you want to share, there are people and in who you really are. You don't have to be a sidekick for somebody else. It's your show. And I think that you can continue to believe in that. Find one other person like I did who sees you, who sees that in you, and build on that and keep going. Just keep going.
Marissa, I cannot say thank you enough for just taking this little time of your busy schedule. I know that you're in beautiful, sunny California, and I know that you got a lot of amazing things coming on your way. Please support Marissa in Goliath. It's just an amazing series. And as well, Shameless with her role of Lynn. That is, you will see both sides of Marissa. One, very serious and strong, with Violet Webster and Lynn more, more as a happy. More a happy Marissa, I should say. And it's really awesome to see you. No, yeah. And I got to say, it's really awesome to see you succeed. It's really awesome to see you accomplish success and finally have this, you know, kind of great roles in your career. And we'd love to see you grow, and we want to see you grow more. And we thank you so much for just being with us today and for allowing us to have this, you know, small little chat. And obviously to promote, you know, Goliath, and, you know, season 3 starts October 4th. Again, I cannot just emphasize this more, but not only that, just speak about your story, a little bit about your story. Some people, they can know more. So Marisa, we thank you so much. Where are people they can find you in social media? Do you have any social media that you would like to, you know, put out there?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yep. On Instagram, it's Marisa Echeverria. So ITS and then my name, Marisa Echeverria. And you can find me on Facebook too. I have a page there. So I hope you check me out and let me know how you like Goliath.
Of course. No. For sure. No, definitely. And we look forward to see Goliath October 4th. Again, Marisa is Violet Webster in this series that is really amazing. Follow Marisa in all social media accounts. It's Marisa Echeverria. In Instagram and as well on her Facebook. Marisa, thank you so much for taking this time. We now leave you, obviously, for you to do some other things in your day. But we thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us today. We really enjoy you.
Thank you. This is such a pleasure.
Thank you so much. And we see you. We look forward to see you in many, many other projects. So all the best. This is your house. Whenever you want to promote anything from your career, you can come to Dialogo and you can definitely talk to us about any project or any crazy stuff that you're going and you're doing on your career. So we thank you again and very proud of what you're doing.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.